Good morning everyone. Welcome to English class. Today we will do a poem, The Field Mouse. And this poem is written by Cecil Frances Alexander. And this poem about a mischievous field mouse that plays around the field. So let's see the first stanza of this poem, where the acorn tumbles down, there the ash tree sits its berry, with your fur so soft and brown, with your eyes so round and merry, scarcely moving the long grass, field mouse, I can see you pass. The field mouse looks from behind a tree, and when the mouse goes fast and starts nibbling the fruits, it makes its resting place at the place which are moss ridden, and the poet tells it to play in the sunny meadow but not destroy the food grains of the farmer. Let's understand this stanza once again. This poem is based on a field mouse which has a soft fur and round eyes and moves through the long grass when the acorn or oak nut fruits and berry falls on the ground. The mouse is seen at this time as it comes out of its hole to eat the fruits. Let's move towards second stanza. So little things, in what dark day lie you all, the winter sleeping, till warm weather comes again, then once more I see you peeping round about the tall tree roots, nibbling at their fallen fruits. In the second stanza, let's see what does the poem want to say through it. The poet asks the mouse what it does during winter season, hiding its hole. The mouse is only seen during summers, peeping from the hole on the trees. The mouse comes out to feed on the fruits of the trees. Let's see the third stanza. Field mouse, field mouse. Field mouse, field mouse, do not go where the farmer stacks his treasure. Find the nut that falls below. Eat the acorn at your pleasure. But you must not steal the grain he has stacked with so much pain. In the third stanza, the poet requests the mouse not to eat the grains that farmers grow by working hard. He requests the mouse to eat only the fruits that are falling on the ground. Let's see the last stanza of this poem. Student, make your last stanza of this poem. Make your hole where mosses spring underneath the tall oak's shadow. Pretty, quiet, harmless thing, play about the sunny meadow. Keep away from corn and house, none will harm you, little mouse. In the last stanza, the poet again requests the mouse to make hole under the tall oak tree and not in the house or near stored grains. And in this way, nobody would harm mouse. Student, let's revise this poem once again. In the first stanza of the poem, The poet describes the field mouse with the soft brown coat and round eyes. In the last two stanzas of the poem, the poet advises the field mouse to eat the fruit that has fallen from trees and not to steal grain from the farmers. He also advises the mouse to make its house in the meadow under the oak. He says if the mouse keeps away from people's homes and their corn, it will not be hurt. Students, let's see some hard words of this poem. Here's the three hard works here. First one is acorn. Acorn means nut of an oak tree. Second one, scarcely means hardly. And stacks, it means heaps. Mosses. Mosses means soft green or brown plants that grow on wet ground, rocks or trees. Student, this is all for today. We will do a story, Pixie in the Pond, in the next class. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.